Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome to Sun and Dark Girl, TERASENE, which is a game by the creator of Death Palette, where you're the sun, and you must protect a girl from things that would steal her away. Chapter 1, Time Passed. She is the girl who would get hurt by the sunshine, so she can go out only during the night. So, this is a game that's basically come from before Death Palette. This was their first game, at least publicly. Get away from her! You become the sun and must defend her. The sun rotates in reverse while you, player, are touching the screen. By using your light, please burn off devils approaching her. I'll also say, I don't really know what the latter part of the title, if that's a real word or not, so you can correct me if it is. I'm trying to debate if it's a pun on something. While her umbrella is on the ground, be careful not to expose her to sunlight as possible. So the things can't hurt her, they can only carry her away, it looks like. We're the ones that can kill her. Interesting. Yeah, look how much damage we do. You can change the type of sunlight from the upper right button. This change needs some orbs. Let's roll back. Get away from her! So as long as that umbrella is up, my lady! Who? My lady, please back to the mansion. If you don't come back, I'll be rebuked by my master. I will bring you back to the mansion by force. Yeah, it's not happening, buddy. Oh, you're like a cute, weird bear with demon wings. Cook Devil Bear. Yo, that title is very fitting. Get away from her. I fight using all my power. Oh god! Cook Devil Bear! Well, let's go to the right! We got you, Bad Devil Bear. You're dead. You can't beat my son. Why is the sun rising at night? I will bring the butler. Where is she going? Why does the sun defend her? They take a long walk at night, and their destination is? Items for lady. Pricey. Hey, did I just beat you? Why are you selling me cash shop items? Pricey. Ouch. I'm sorry, my lady, but I also need money to live. It's because my master pays me a low salary. I want to eat rare salmon steak. Last evening, my dinner was only a piece of broiled salmon skin. The day before yesterday, I ate only a bit of flaked salmon. My lady, please decide to buy now. Chapter 1, time passed. Chapter 2, you fell in love again. Leaving the mansion, she came to a human town. There's like a story hidden here. I think a lot of this is a very symbolic game. She still continues walking. You can kind of tell when we start the chapters, there's like a little freeze frame on the left. Please land the way she walks. Let's check out the shop. So here's the cash shop, let's see. You unlock orbs for just playing, but you know, you can just kind of cash shop because it's a free game. Single, radiates a ray of standard light, is easy for beginner to use. 2 speed, 2 attack, limit time infinite. Cross garden, emits narrow lights in the direction of the cross. It can defend against attacks from both sides, but its power is weaker than single. Let's try cross garden. It's a little weaker, but let's try it out. Yeah, this is kind of working out, because the bats are coming from both directions. No, mouse! Well, you know what, mouse? You should have never been here in the first place, okay? My lady, I found you. Such a happy son. Yeah, go away. Go away, big bat. Mouse! You know what? Mice are vicious. Yeah, I'm not dealing with that. Power's about to go off. Now a normal sun again. Please stop, my lady. You wanna go? What are you? Please look, instead of the moon, the visible sun shines tonight. Please go back to the mansion, my lady. Oh yeah, it's the butler. Butler Manchester. Go away, buddy. Might have to unlock some powers. The three-way would really turn him up. I feel like it's gonna be a little overpowered. Crossgarden's fine. No. Get away from her. Because it's got a good angle for this. Keep the bats away too. Get out of here, buddy. Get out of here. Medlida, I can stand how you feel, but please have mercy on our servants. Oh, big bat. Two over here. Took out the big bat. Just finish off the butler. Power's running out. There it is. Got you both. Your way is protected. Shoot, we can't charge the power of magic without the moon. That can only inform and bring the master. You're like a vampire trying to run away from your family. Both the cook and the butler were repelled. And as you still continue walking, the daybreak is still far. Oh look, it's colored in. Hold up. Sun's kind of peeking through the window. Time passed, you fell in love again. Sees a sun, sees a boy in the garden. Chapter 3, I'm so jealous. She came from far away from the mansion. She went through a town and then a bridge appeared ahead of her. Hey, how you doing? I'm the sun. Could you safely cross the bridge? Don't worry, I got you. Ain't no bats coming near you, girl. Nice bridge. Keep a default shot for now. This difficulty is still relatively low, but that's probably going to increase later. My dear! My dear! Big bat. You come back here. Ain't no run. There's a lot of big bats. Small bats. You're getting overwhelmed. Get away from her. Would you make her trip? We're good. My dear, I surely forbade you going out. Who dare challenges us in our path, guarded by the sun? You are a cliche vampire. Go back to the mansion. Beyond here is not our territory. Dangerous wolves and the witch wander there. Damn, the disgusting sun. I'll not permit anyone approaching to my daughter. Dad, go get some milk and don't come back. Family head Abraham. Let's see whatever powers we have. Three-way. Hard to hit a target. Whoa! I'm shooting Dan Maku. Sweet. Die! Father-in-law. I'm gonna shoot some bullets at you. Yeah, it does hit hard, but like... they do have a little slight tendency to miss. I see what they mean. He's dead, forget it. Oh no. Oh! Oh, how did... you can't even shoot the sun. How'd you shoot the sun of lightning? Power's fading. Ow! Nope. The bumble sun, don't expose my daughter to your light. Ow! Get out of here, Dad. No, no, I almost killed her. I got you. Family head Abraham. Please, please wait. Actually, that boy. Master, you're becoming ash. Let's go to the back to the mansion at once. Damn. Her father also was repelled. So I remember when I was playing Death Pal, I was like, oh, the girl looks like Remilia. And I'm kind of like, yeah. And then she still continues walking. What will you and the girl meet after crossing the bridge? So this is a literal game. Maybe it's just, Big Sun. Big Sun just guarding this vampire girl to go find her true love. There it is in color. Chapter 3, I'm so jealous. Now we move on to chapter 4, I want you to look at me. You see the dad here is like really angry. The other side of the bridge is a deep forest. Humans never enter there at night. A pack of terrible beasts are approaching to her silently. Don't worry, I got you. You and me, we stick in together. I'm the sun. Everyone loves the sun. Wolves, go away! Snakes? These are just normal snakes and wolves. Predetermined little buggers, though. Is this the smell of a human? I don't think that's human. They kind of burn in sunlight. And their family are bats. I don't think they're human. Go away, snakes. Maybe a girl. I got a chance of approach to a girl. Nope. Coming on sides. keeping him in check. Cut it out, doggos. Hello, cute little lady. I don't like that. What the? I am a lonely wolf living in this forest. Feel like you're like a damn come from altered beast. In order to forget loneliness, I've trained my body every day and I got this muscular body. Probably fake gains. But I am hungry for love. I'm gonna shoot you with sunbeams. There's nothing you can do about it. Lady, couldn't you have an affection for this lovely wolf? Don't worry, I got you, girl. Muscular lonely wolf. What's this next power? Accordion. It radiates a wide light after storing up power. It can burn off a wide range powerfully. Prefer not to burn off your important thing to give her. Sure. Oh, I can see what they meant by that. Oh, yeah, this can kill her really easy. It's too powerful. I burned her alive. I was too strong. Okay, start with default beam. Because the stronger beams, inevitably, the problem is there's like a little bit of like a cooldown before you activate the new beam, and then that time frame, you already like knocked off an umbrella, and then the new beam just ends up killing you. No, go away, Swole Wolf. Leave her be. Just wants to live a normal life. For love interest. Come on. Fret it. Just take the hit. Wait, activate this power. Frost Garden. It's not gonna kill the boss very fast, but it's gonna keep these other doggos at bay. It's important we keep him tamed, or we get overwhelmed really fast. God, they don't stop. I think we've stopped the doggo wave, though. Just tank and spank. Power's gonna be deactivated in a sec. Just enough. Oh, I beat you. My suit of armor looks like a muscular body is broken. I got it with great difficulty. I imagine that muscular. Please keep this secret. Go back to the gym. Yes, the way out of this forest. I shall guide you there with pleasure. With the help of a lonely wolf. Let's go to the way out of the forest. He has disguised himself as a muscular wolf with a suit of armor. It will be concealed by the veil of this night forever. Now we move on to, however, to be honest. After passing through the forest to say goodbye to a lonely wolf, she arrived to a ruined castle. It was once a beautiful castle staying near the sea. Now it ought to be uninhabited, but the footsteps of someone else are heard. Let's go. The sun here. Oh no, skeletons. I like the touch how there are skeletons that you light up when you like shine on them. It's just the skeleton that's lighting up, nothing else. Out. Back skeletons! But they're really determined. It's almost like they're undead or something. Good thing skeletons don't exist. Clash, clash. Ooh, we're burning her up. Can't. Get up, girl. Oh, no. We're gonna get her. No, she's dead. Too many skeletons. You know what would be a good power to use? The really strong one. They don't stop, but they are slow. Accordion. Their skirt. Like, it's not perfect. It has its weaknesses too, as you can see. That cooldown time can be deadly. What are you? Frankenstein? I'll not allow you to enter this place. What is the reason not to allow entering? I can't remember it. However, you do not leave, I will not overlook your trespass. Still got this power here. Gotta be a little bit careful with it. Yeah, Frankenstein. Andrew Brocken. Is that a reference? The name it is. You drop gears. You're also really tanky. And you're gonna... Gear. I can't take the gear off, or it's gonna murder her. Forgot what I once had been guarding, Normal. It's fine. This works. Don't need to have you any overkill shots. Why am I here? I think you're holding a flower, right? Yeah. This is a Frankenstein reference. You're kind of similar to Wolf, but you're not as... You're tankier, but not as strong. Oh. What a strong and gentle light. I feel as if my head was beginning to clear. Oh. I remember. I was the guardian of this castle. The cut-off witch cut-off witch lives in the cemetery behind the castle, but no one knows when she came there. In the fight against the witch, my memory was destroyed by her. Masters and soldiers of this castle were also cut off by the witch. If you have precious feelings, you must not go to the Midnight Graveyard. Chapter 6, I Wish You Happiness, So. The back of the old castle is a wide cemetery. She steps into there and looks at the gravestones one by one. Whose gravestone is she looking for? The boys. Oh god, there's ghosts! Wait, they're coming back for round 2! I think we need to have the double shot pretty soon. You know what? Nope. Let's go 3-way shot. Oh dear. You are a holder of strong feelings. It's been a long time since such came. I think it's the rest of the dialogue before it all played. So many ghosts! Zombie ghosts, be gone from this place. I'm on a quest of love and sun. I can see 2 strong feelings. Oh god, the shadow snakes! Go away. Go away, shadow snakes. And zombie guests. Thank you for coming. Hello there. I feel 2 strong emotions are directed at someone. One comes from the sky and is turned toward you, Mademoiselle. The other is yours and is turned toward the dark water. There is not your beloved here. My favorite thing is the despair of those who lost their precious feelings. Now is the time to cut off. Here we go, Toho battle. Cut off witch. Meet bear shots. Not yet. Accordion. Get out of here. Go back to Toho where you belong. I shall cut off your love for him perfectly. Don't cut a sis- Ah! 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 Save me! Save me! I'm the son! I'm not supposed to be getting stabbed by scissors! Get away from her! Memories are precious things. You won't take them. My power is running low. Getting to end another shot type soon. The sun. Your light will never reach her. It's reaching her right now. Ow, 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 ouch, 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 ouch. Get up, get up, get up. Ow! No! It stunned me to murder her! I see how that works. Ouch. Gut. Mademoiselle, your beloved is at the bottom of the Dark Sea. He's sleeping in a cradle out there. As long as a very strong will of someone captures him, he'll never awake. I wonder if you can cut his chains. Nero sees she's depressed. Everyone's trying to cheer her up. Wish you happiness, so, and then I'll be the light to guide you. I think this is the final chapter. After going for the Greyborn, she arrived at the Dark Sea. You and she hear the sound of waves and breathing of someone asleep. I might get my shot ready early. Yeah. Let's do the freeway shot. Looks like I wasn't quite sure if the star actually damaged her, rather than steal her away. Two-way shot might also be useful here. Someone's asleep. Stars are coming in heavy. Switch shots before we have a little leeway. Cross garden! Who wakes me up? Yeah, the stars do actual damage, they don't just take her away. So if you let some through, you actually just let him hit, she'll recharge. No, that's what's gonna hurt. Yeah, this is working out. It's noisy. Who is here? The moon? What? Are you the daughter of Abraham? You believe your father's line came to the graveyard, right? When Admiral Girl, I will tell you the truth. Your beloved is here. Your father was afraid that you might leave the mansion without attention to your weakness for sunlight. So he hid this boy in the moon and said the lie that he died. Is it true, though? If this boy keeps sleeping in the cradle of the moon, he will soon forget you. But look, this is a really cute boy. I decided to make this boy mine. Don't blame me. It's all your father's fault. The sun, why do you blame me? Why don't you do as you like, too? No way, man. Sun's on the side of love. Do you intend to pass up a chance again? What a great gentleman you are. But your light would make that girl ash. At night, the moon is stronger than the sun. You can't defeat me with your weakened strength. I'll make you and the girl sleep together. This is just a plot in the Kirby games. Forever. Crescent Moon. Let's go, Sun Bros! Not bad, the sun. That star's gonna hit. Just let it hit. It's fine. The weakest shot type is actually probably pretty useful right here, because it's covering the stars really well. The stronger one might get us killed. Because it's not gonna screen many of these stars coming in. Ooh. There goes my power. Needing an opening. Quick, flare skirt. You are a cheeky girl. Wait. Consuming the tears, the moon will become available. You sure intend to defeat me? Of course I will. Don't have an opening to activate a new ability. Now. Cross garden. Just here, take the hit. She'll tank that. Whoa, moon! Yeah, make sure my light's not on you when that hits. I'll never give you. Burn and become ash. Why is there meteors coming down? Well, you are the moon, I guess. Yeah, those meteors hit really hard. I need more power. Need more power. That tamed that a little bit. Accordion. I think we did. The moon's defeated. Now all the tides will be messed up. And mankind dies. The sun. Why do you disturb me? The sun. Are you really satisfied with your choice? There's no one I mean. However earnestly we watch and light up someone, those efforts never are rewarded. Why? Why so? Wake up. Man, I'm a pretty bummed out son. Come on. Praise the sun, Umbasa. Did the sun just go inside him? Thank you. That's my bow. Cute little sketches. Dang, the moon is really upset. Like, hey, what's up? I'm the sun. Is the moon and the sun going out now? Are they going like a date? Poyo. So he put out his lantern, she got her umbrella out. It's like she said, hey, don't worry, me and the sun. I feel lonely. The sun, you know, is like, oh man, I can't light their life anymore. So I'm gonna pop out the umbrella, you turn off your lantern, we're good, we don't need it. Thank you for playing. Hard mode is open. Let's start with a true story. I'll be the light to guide you. Oh, look! There's something on the right. This must be a story about the mom. Because you remember we saw in the portrait. It's a hard story of the girl and you. So I'm not sure if this is gonna unlock new cutscenes or something. So in that case, then, if I don't see anything that really much different, I'll just cut to the new cutscenes. So this is the hard ending. I'm not sure if this dialogue is different. It might be slightly so. This ending wasn't colored in the original one, right? Wasn't it just an outline before? End. Thank you for playing. So now that we've been both hard and normal mode, we can see the kind of parallels in the story. So time passed. On the left, it's the girl kind of cooped up in her house, unable to see the sun because she's a vampire, she burns up in light. On the right, we see not Dracula here. It's kind of following a woman, the sun's out there, sun's like pretty happy. Chapter 2, You Fell in Love Again. Here, she finally opens up the window and sees a boy out there. Sun's kind of like, hey, what's going on? On the right, Sun's kind of noticing this guy over there, about to give like a confession letter saying, hey, what's going on? You fell in love again? I'm so jealous. So this is actually from the son's perspective, if you get to look at. Time passed, you fell in love again, I'm so jealous. So she starts talking to the boy, the son's like, hey. Here she, Dracula, or Abraham, starts talking to the woman. In the shade of the tree, son's like, hey. Chapter 4, I want you to look at me. This one's just her family's kind of like upset. Like, oh, human boy. This one's just the moon out there chilling. Chapter 5, however, to be honest. On the left, we see the father make the deal with the moon to give the boy over. Son's kind of seeing what's going on, Pollo. On the right, their daughter is born and the son's very happy. Chapter 6, I wish you happiness, so. Here, she's upset because the boy is gone, her boyfriend. Son's kind of like sad, sees him being sad. In this one, they realize that the daughter inherited the son weakness on the right. And then chapter 7, I'll be the light to guide you. So on the left, the sun came out at night, somehow, because it wants to help her out. She has the umbrella. And on the right, first off, they've blocked the sun out, as you can tell. Because like she can't see the sun, because she's sensitive to the light. And it looks like also her mom has passed away. So the sun is just kind of grieving on the outside. So let's go in the book. This is just for the characters. Bat. A bat is familiar use by the clan. It has a small body but has supernatural strength and is able to lift my lady easily. I suspect it may be stronger than a bear. Cook Devil Bear. Is the handsome cook who serves at the mansion. He originally lived in the forest. He hopes to stuff himself with bloody salmon. Little developer self-insert. But salary is low, so today's dinner is flake salmon. Story. Oh, okay, cool. So we can actually read the dialogue. And the hard dialogue does have differences. So the hard version, it's almost the same dialogue, but it's like slightly expanded. So it kind of starts here. My lady, will you please go to the mansion and come back? I'll be rebuked by my master. It shows the differences here in the red color, see? If you go away, my salary will decrease again. I take you back by all means. Oh, at this rate, my salary is bound to decrease. I'll fight using all my power. It's a nice touch. They actually, like, separate the dialogues with the differences. And then the dangerous night has just begun. And then blue, you see, this is exclusive to the blue, no more out. Night Mouse. Night Mouse is a nocturnal small animal living out of town. At night, it becomes active and runs between many hiding places at full speed. Please be careful not to trip on it. Balloon Bat is familiar becoming fat like a balloon. It moves slowly, but it's terribly tough. Actually, it's a monster. Possibly may have been given better foods than mine. Butler Manchester. Butler Manchester has served in the mansion for a long time. His ancestors were creatures swimming in the sea, called a manta ray. I don't know the reasons they came up to land. Story. So we've already seen the normal version. I'll show you the hard version, because I didn't show my playthrough of that. The master forbids you leave the mansion unnecessarily, even if at night. Like your mother, what a strong heart you have. If it keeps going like this, you will become ash. What's the difference there? Abraham. My master Abraham is the current head of the clan, my lady's father. He dotes on and worries for his daughter because Madame died young. Also, he worries about his hair recently becoming gray. Story. What a stubborn girl. Whom do you resemble in that disposition? He died and was buried in a cemetery. Forget it. Why are you constantly lighting up my daughter? Do you intend to take revenge on me? I told her that way for your own good. Please understand. Once I lost her, and if I've lost you now, I will. The son, if you can't defend my daughter until I come back, I will not forgive you. Manchester and Bear, I will reduce your salary.
Oh, no!
Yeah, so quite a bit of dialogue differences in that one. Hellsnake. Hellsnake inhabits the forest and graveyards. Bitten by it, even the devil bear cries in pain, so you should not step into the forest. Helldog is a wild dog living in the forest. It is gentle by nature, but is forced by one muscular wolf to attack humans who enter there, I hear. Muscular only wolf. Looks like Foxy. Muscular only wolf is the ruler of the forest. He looks muscular, but he really has a feeble body, I hear. He disguises with a suit of armor that he got in the nearby ruined castle. Hard mode story. Yes, I got a chance at love. Hello, mademoiselle. Stop lighting up. Your light penetrates my suit of armor and reveals my real figure. And that's it, pretty much. Ghost Knight was an undead soldier of the Rune Castle. It walks by keeping the rhythm of riding, I guess, because I rode a warhorse while alive. Android Brocken. Android Brocken was made by alchemists of the castle's guardian. When the castle was destroyed by the witch, his memory was cut off by her, and he forgot everything regarding his masters, I hear. I feel like Brocken, it might be a reference to a Kinuku man, a certain character from that, who is also an android. Hard dialogue difference, I have a headache, it makes me recall something. None of my masters whom I have guarded exists here. However, I will keep the memories of them forever. Zombie, was originally a corpse buried in the graveyard, but now has a false life and drags a person to the ground. Unexpectedly, it looks charming under the light, but I think it's less charming than me. Spirit, is a soul separated from a corpse. It wanders around aimlessly and fires a tree and so on. I think it's very troublesome. Cut off witch. Cut off witch appears in a cemetery, but no one knows when she came there. She makes dead people rest by breaking off their regrets. On the other hand, she cuts off memories and lives lives of living people. Hard mode story. The sun, I shall also cut off the broken heart that has been distressing you for a long time. Star, twinkles in the night sky usually, but once it becomes a shooting star, it will inflict damage directly. Of course, the umbrella can't protect my lady from this damage. Meteorite, is a big rock falling down from the sky. If it hits my lady, she will encounter a far more terrible accident than dropping her umbrella. So please be careful. Really, is this necessary? The moon is the last one here. The moon is the ruler of the night sky. It has kept an old friendship with our clan. My lady used to sleep in the cradle of the moon in her babyhood, but sometimes we are troubled that it was a weakness for a young boy. Story. Hard mode. I hear from noises from above. It's noisy. Anyone should be quiet at night. You like this girl, don't you? Then it's lucky for you that a nuisance this boy disappears. The boy and you will become unhappy like your parents. When you were born, I blessed you. You are an ungrateful girl. The sun, are you really satisfied only with being reminded of the look of your beloved looking at this girl? If you let the girl meet the boy, you'll be forgotten, become unable to light up her forever. Why so? So the dialogue actually makes more sense. A little more in the hard mode. So that's it for The Sun and The Dark Girl. So I like both of the games from this crew. I like Death Paladin, I like this one. They're both very different games. I know they do have a third game coming out, and I think it stars some kind of cute witch. This one is more arcadey, but it still has a little bit of heart to it. I will say, I didn't keep it in the playthrough because it would just kind of drag down the length a bit. But the hard mode of the game is considerably harder than the normal mode. I would actually argue that the hard mode is kind of the intended difficulty. Because it just throws a ton of enemies at you, and they have a like decent amount of health. But you do have to use the upgrades. You will probably not survive with the default beam. But hard mode kind of brings the mechanics to the front. In the default difficulty, you only get to really feel the mechanics at the last couple of stages or so. But it's a fun mechanic. So you really only like a few things actually kill the girl. The rest of them just drag her off. So it's kind of like, it's a little poetic, right? Like, the sun wants to protect her, but the sun is also the one that will, in fact, kill her. It kind of represents the story in itself, where the sun, not so much like, oh, I want to date you, marry a romance, but more of a, it's developed kind of a romance of love, like a kind of distance crush on these girls. The first, the mom, and then the daughter. It's more of like an appreciative of beauty kind of thing, I think. But in the latter case, it can't look over her, even though it liked the mom. It can't watch over her because it will burn her alive. So it just, you know, depressed the sun out. So it lost its first love, both in the sense of it married away to the vampire, but also because she passed away. And then it can't bestow its love to the daughter because, like I said, she'll burn up because she's half vampire. So it's kind of like, the best way to think of it is like how people kind of worship the sun. I don't mean like Dark Souls, but I mean like, the sun is, you know, a heavenly body, like a heavenly father, brings life and everything. So that's how its kind of love is kind of represented. It cannot bring life to this girl. The moon is usually a representation of, like, illusions. It's at the bottom of a sea because, you know, reflection of the moon. And moons are always represented by the distraction, obscuring, kind of stuff like that. That's why it took the boy away and is a little more antagonistic here. But in the end, it looks like the sun and the moon kind of get together. And also the girl says, like, you know what? I'm going to keep using my umbrella because I felt bad for the sun. The sun really helped me out. So the sun kind of gets what they want. It's a happy ending all around. The girl ends up with the boy. The father learns to, like, lay off. The moon learns to chill. The sun is happy. So, very simple, but pretty effective emotionally story. But yeah, anyway. So, thank you all for watching me play The Sun and the Dark Girl. I'll see you guys later, and take it easy.